In this video, we're going to look at the parts of the light microscope, as well as how to determine magnification and the field of view. Light microscopes use a combination of lenses and light to magnify objects. The light microscope lets one be able to view objects in their natural color, as well as view stains used to highlight certain structures. The parts of the light microscope are the eyepiece, also known as the ocular lens, which is where you look into the microscope, the eyepiece tube, the revolving nosepiece, which the objectives are attached to, the arm, the stage, which is where you put your slide, the stage clips that hold your slide in place. Underneath the stage is the diaphragm, also known as the condenser. There is a coarse adjustment knob and a fine adjustment knob. At the bottom, you have the base as well as the light source. How do you work out the magnification of the object you are looking at through the microscope? Magnification is the amount in which something has been magnified compared to its real size, in other words, how much bigger it appears. To determine the total magnification, you times the magnification of the ocular lens, the eyepiece, by the magnification of the objective lens used. The magnification of the ocular lens should be written on the side of it or in the user manual. The objective lenses have the magnification written on the side of the lenses. If you have an ocular lens with the magnification of 10 times, and you are using the objective with the magnifying power of 4 times, the total magnification would equal 40 times. If you have the same ocular lens, as this doesn't change, but instead we're looking at the object now with the 10 times objective lens, it would be 10 times by 10 times, with a total magnification of 100 times. When looking through the microscope, there is going to be a circular area you can see. This is called the field of view. The field of view diameter is simply the diameter of this field of view. When on low power magnification, you can measure the field of view diameter directly by placing a transparent ruler under the objective. You then need to focus the microscope to the lines on the ruler and measure the diameter in millimeters. So here we would have a diameter of 2.5 millimeters, rounded to one significant digit. When the power of magnification gets higher, the smaller the field of view diameter, and using direct measurement is not suitable. The field of view diameter can still be determined at higher power magnifications using an equation that uses the measurement taken at the lower power magnification. You times the diameter measured at the lower power by the magnification of the lower power objective, then divide this by the magnification of the higher power objective. So if our measurement was 2.5 millimeters for the low power objective lens 4 times, and we were trying to work out the field of view diameter with the objective lens for 100 times, we would times 2.5 by 4, then divide by 100, which gives a field of view of 0.1 millimeter, which we can convert to a more useful measurement of micrometers of 100 micrometers. How then do you estimate the size of a specimen or other sample in the field of view? If we look at this paramecium under high magnification of 100 times, the first thing you need to be able to do is find out the field of view diameter as previously explained, which gave us a field of view diameter of 100 micrometers. You then need to estimate the fraction of this field of view diameter the sample takes up. This paramecium takes up around 1/10 of the field of view diameter. You then need to multiply the field of view diameter by this estimated fraction to get the estimated size of the specimen. If the field of view diameter was 100 micrometers and the estimated length to be around 1/10, so 0.1 of the field of view diameter, it would be 100 micrometers times 0.1, which gives an estimated size of 10 micrometers. Another way to estimate the size of a sample is to count how many times the object would fit across the field of view, and then divide the field of view diameter by this count. If the field of view diameter was still 100 micrometers, and around 10 paramecium would fit across the field of view diameter, then it would be 100 micrometers divided by 10, which gives us an estimated size of around 10 micrometers. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.